Hello and welcome. I'm Professor Tsuchiya, and I'll be guiding you through this introductory course on using Simulink to simulate dynamic systems. Before we finally build and simulate the dynamic response of an automobile, we need to learn how Simulink is integrated with MATLAB. Since Simulink is a MathWorks product, it communicates seamlessly with the MATLAB environment. In other words, Simulink can read variables in the MATLAB workspace, and MATLAB can call Simulink simulations from the command line. Let's see how this works with a simple block diagram. A constant input is to be scaled by a certain value, A, via the gain block, and the output is sent to the scope. You can directly type the variable A into the gain block and run the simulation. Not surprisingly, we see an error indicating that Simulink does not know what the variable A is. To remedy this, you can either manually enter a constant value into the gain block, or you can define the variable A in the MATLAB workspace. Notice that the variable A now exists in the MATLAB workspace. Now, Simulink recognizes this variable and assigns the value to the variable A in the simulation, and it runs with no errors. This is an example of how Simulink can read variables from the MATLAB workspace. Up until now, we have only been viewing the simulation results from within Simulink via the scope block. However, viewing the data is much like seeing the result of a computation in the MATLAB command window. In other words, once you close the scope, the data is gone. In typical engineering applications, it is desired to save the simulation data and analyze it at a later time. An easy way to do this is to replace the scope block with a to workspace block from the Syncs submenu in the library browser. Double-click the block and rename it to something that makes sense to you. It is also recommended to switch the save format from time series to array. This allows the data to be saved as a standard MATLAB vector for easy plotting at a later time. It is also common practice to include a clock from the sources submenu to keep track of the simulation time so that you have an independent variable against which to plot. You can make a copy of the to workspace block and rename it appropriately. Let's change the source from a constant to a sine wave as well so that the output is more interesting to look at. Running the simulation now, you notice that nothing appears to happen. In other words, there's no graph to look at. Upon closer inspection, however, the workspace, which previously only contained the variable A, now contains several vectors. The first is the actual data Y, the second is the time variable that you created, and the third is the default time vector, included by many recent releases of Simulink. I still recommend creating your own time vector on each simulation, because sometimes the default time vector, T out, is not of the same length as the data vectors, which makes plotting very difficult. Now that you have the actual data from the simulation stored in your workspace, you can plot and analyze it with ease. The last thing I want to show you is that Simulink models can be called from MATLAB remotely. In other words, once you build and save your model, you can put it away and simply call it from MATLAB at any time using the sim function. Let's write a very basic script that will run the simulation that we just created. You'll need to save your simulation first before closing it. Then in your script, you can call the name of that file to run the simulation remotely. Once the line of code is executed to simulate the system, you can post-process the data as you wish. Now that you've seen the interconnection between MATLAB and Simulink, we are ready to build and simulate our first dynamic system, which we'll do in the next video.